everyone, welcome to Athril Studio. How are you all today? Is it okay? Can you hear me or can you listen to me? Just write a yes. Hello everyone. Okay, great. Thank you, Hansini. So today is our day 4 of Sora Art, and today we are going to create a painting which will be having a lot of activity, the gods, the prayer, all that, all the dances, all the animals. We'll do a lot which we have not done in the past sessions. Good afternoon, everyone. Okay, so are we all ready? I will place the camera on my workplace and then you can have a look on the stuff that we are going to do today. So there we go, on the table. Okay, so here is the black paper and I have made a border just to save time. We have already done borders before. So you can choose your own border, whichever border you want to do, you may do that and that's going to be perfect. Here you can do a single border also or the double border, depends on your wish. And what I will be using is a jelly roll white and the size is 10. So if you see that there is a 5, 7, you will see that they are a little thin. So what is this number? This is significant of its size. So this will give you good white bold lines. So the border is complete and what we will be doing will be, we will be segregating it into sections. We all know, just recapping the history of it, that these are different from Varli paintings but very similar because they are the pictographs and they are done by as wall murals by the Sora tribe, which is the very big tribe, and it's the most primitive tribe. It is also said that in Ramayana we must have heard about Shabri. She was one from this tribe. So the difference, again, the border is very important, and whenever you see the Sora art you will see that the pictures are divided into panels and sections. So whatever the activity is, there is a border which is separating it. It is never going to be like Varli everywhere. It won't be scattered. It is more structured and planned. And these paintings were done by only the priests and not the commoners of the tribe. So we will start. So if you do not have a black paper, you can always do a black and a white. So take a white paper and do it with black pen. That is okay. But authentically, the Sora tribe, they used to do the painting with the seashell powder, which is the calcium. So seashells were grinded and with that, they used to paint. You may put dots also. Dots, lines, and these conical patterns are very important. They are very peculiar. You will see this in all the Sora paintings. Reason being that these are the symbols for the mountains, as they were the dwellers in the mountain areas which were next to the Vasundhara river. And that is where they get the seashells, and that is what is their life. They are hunters and gatherers from the hills. Okay, so we will start and just do a border, and then with the use of a scale I will just divide the panels, few panels, and you may do it. I use two scales. That's what everybody asks, why do you use two scales? I use one scale as the base so that my ink doesn't get spread. Okay, so if sometimes you will see that if you do it like this, some of the ink will be sticking to your edge of your scale, and when you will remove it, it will get scattered and then it will spoil your picture. So I just take a little thick one which is in the bottom and then I place the other one so that I get the line straight and still it will not touch the scale. So here, without touching, this line is made. For few of my lining work or the borders in other arts also, I use this trick. So this is a quick, clever way of doing it and not spoiling it. Here, so I'll just divide it into few bands. You may reduce or increase the thickness. There is no set pattern that it has to be thick or thin. Just like so, and I'm doing three of them. You may make these borders elaborate also, which I will show you one, all different types of borders I will show, and then it will be easier for you to understand that you can go any which way you want. There is no set pattern for this. Okay, so I have made three lines over here. I will be doing a little more elaborate border. Okay, so now we will take this away, and all of them is very, very neat. There we go. Now we will just fill up the borders quick. So before just putting your hands on anything which you have done right now, it's always advised to check. Otherwise, many of my students and many of the followers have always told me that they use the nib and the ink and they spoil by putting their hands on. So be very, very careful. Okay, so here I'm just doing a small border. So this is just a crisscross going all around, and then I'm just putting a few dots, lines. Everything here is all geometric, but unlike the figures are a little flowy and curvier as compared to the varli. We don't actually really compare the art because it is very respectful for them. But my personal liking is Saura, because when those long females are dancing, somehow it appeals to me more than Varli, just for that aspect. So here, this. Now, we will be working on the lower portion after some time. I will be going on the top portion. Now, waiting for it to dry. It's still not dry. I have got two dots, so we'll wait for some time. So now here I will be taking the center of my page. Yeah, and that's it. And I will be drawing few lines here. You may do the curve any which way you want. You may do it pointed also, you may do it curve also. So I will just shift it like this because this line is still wet. So here, and the same way here. I'm not measuring it, just like this. And giving it a nice dome shape. Like this. Again, do the double outline for this. So this is the place where I will be placing the god. They do have the god, and the god is called Idithal. And I've repeated that information many a times, but if in case you've forgotten it, so Idithal is the main god, and the prayers are done for Idithal or for the ancestors. All the people in the tribe, they want to please their ancestors and the main god, which is Idithal. So here, then again, I'm just making these curved tops, pointy tops. When you hold your any of these white pens, I would advise you hold it in an upright position, like a perpendicular. Hold it perpendicular. The ink of it flows very well when you hold it like this. If you hold it in a tripod position, like you hold while you're writing, then you might have some patches, like some places you will not have a very good flow. So this is how we're going to fill the whole thing with bold, right? Okay, Meg. Yes, next is our 3D mandala. We have done many of the mandalas, but we have not done 3D mandalas. We will be doing in our next session. I will be telling you about 3D mandalas, how to go 3D and how to do the inverse mandala. There are different types of mandalas. There are so many innovations that you can do. Once you know the design, the patterns, or you make your own patterns, then you can go endlessly making your mandala. But there are few things and few ways in which you can present your mandala, which will give a total, the visual effect will be totally different. Sometimes it creates the optical illusion. Sometimes it's a very nice flower mandala. Sometimes it's half mandala and half drawing. So there's so many, but the 3D mandala looks very, very pretty. So we'll do that also in the next session. We will be doing that. And thereafter, we will be taking another folk art. So our sessions will be like one time we'll just go a little contemporary in the ongoing arts, and then we will go with our folk arts. So here, this is a small enclosure that is made for the god. Now, giving it a little higher, the curve over here. Now again, a big torso. Front position leg. Fill up the whole thing. The head. The hands. And here. The weapons, as they were hunters. Here. Now, there are a few people who are all around. So, just making them bent like this. like they are in the praying position, bent down. Now here, hands joined, and this is the position. Like this. So these figures will look very, very tiny in front of the Irithal. Just making a male here. Hands all joined. So this is a small depiction of how the prayers were made. And they do a lot of offerings also. We have done it before. Just creating a little more. Broader border. It'll look nice. And then the Irithals will sit down over here and do the prayer. This. So few of the people sitting down here, you don't have to go very symmetrical on it, just the hands and the legs. The main form should be conveying the message that they are sitting or they are standing, but they will not bend by the knee. They will not bend from the knee. Yes, yes, Aruda. So here, now here I'm making a big tree, because tree is one thing that they used to pray a lot. After the Irithal, where trees were the most sacred thing. Sure, I'll just give you a zoom in view also. So I'm just making two straight lines right here. And this way here. I will just give you a zoom picture of how it looks. So this is the way. You can take any black paper. You can take any black paper. It is carbon black. What I am using is the carbon black. So this is the tree, and I am making few of the birds over here. All over the tree. So this is a very simplest, it is the simplest form of making the tree. It is very symbolic. It is not the real kind of a tree that you will see, but you will see that the tree, in the tree there will be a lot of birds. And this will also give a little symmetrical look when you are doing it. So So just filling it. If in case you want to fill it with your acrylic paint, you can fill it with acrylics also. So here I have made one over this side and the other I will be making on this side. So if you are liking my video, do not forget to press the like button and also the bell, because when I will be I will be announcing any workshop, then you will get the reminders on that. And we do it every Saturday and Sunday. I'm just repeating it every time because people are joining in new with me. And thank you all for those who have already subscribed. Those who have not, do subscribe. And here, another one. So we're just repeating the same. You may change the form of them, like the face, this side or that side, doesn't matter. For the Sora, I might be posting more videos when I will be doing different form of Sora paintings. But our live sessions for Sora, this is the last one. So this finishes with our upper area here, and I will be making the sun. And here there is one bird flying like this. I will be making one or two monkeys here. There's a lot of space, so we will be filling it with the monkeys. They are always there in the hills. And the same I will be doing on the other side. There. So this is the top panel that is complete now. Going on to the second panel, we will be showing what their animals they were around. Okay. Okay, so now is the animals, and we will just make a trail of animals moving, different animals that were taken. So you will get to know how we make the animals. So first one is the goat. I think we covered that one before also, but just in case. And again, the belly part of all the animals will go solid colored. If you are doing black or white, whatever color is, just fill it up like this. That's the goat. And a man carrying a boat. Goat, sorry, boat I'm saying. Here, this. So, because it's, this is being taken that side, it is going to be like. So, this. Again, I will be filling it dark. I'll lower the camera so that you can have a cool, good view of that. Yeah. This. Now the next one is a cow. Just two humps, slant here, flat body and the legs. The tail. This way and this is how we do the cup. Now this is also being taken and we'll put the rope here. And the man is carrying a stick also. We will be filling the whole thing with white. Like so. Now the next we will do is the horse. What is it about what? What is it about what? What do you want? I mean like your question is not very clear to me. Now for the horse we make a flat top. And flat top and the bottom will be like this. The neck will be up straight and this is the head. Now we will make the ears a little rounded and then the mane. So mane is only the hair sticking out and so just position like this and the tail will be a little open like a. So you will see with slight variations, still your images which are at their most simplest form are able to convey what they are made. So this one and here again let me make a one man sitting over here. So or a boy, whatever you can. With a stick. Right there. All the animals are being taken. So, this will give you the idea of how the animals are made. Now the most mightiest one we'll put, yes that's a jelly roll pen, white. Now the mightiest one we'll make it a little bigger and that is the elephant. So humped, very curved, big belly, small legs, a small tail, and a clothing over it. It's been tied up like this, and with no neck, it goes like this, and one line which symbolizes the ivory of it. So there, here also we can have people sitting and holding spears. So this is you can film this portion totally. And this. So now you all know with me what is Sora and what is Varli. So quickly, just 10 replies. I will just check. Let's check the poll. Who likes Sora more or Varli? Just write Sora if you like Sora. If you like Varli, write the Varli. So I'll just have a quick survey on that. So now, because you know both, you will be able to make your own decision as your which art form you're fond of. Sora, okay. Both, Sora. Sora, okay. Wow. So, many of the people, they don't know about this art form. And often if you don't know the minutes of this art, often people mistake it as Varli only. Yes, Sora is a little difficult because the flow has to be determined. The movement is there. The dances and all are very... Yes, Varli is much easier than this. Yeah. So now we'll go on to the second one here. That this is like the prayer is going on. This is what the animals are. Every panel can show a different kind of activity. They are not necessary. It's not necessary that they have to be interconnected. No. Okay. So here we're going on to the other one. And we can show the hunting happening here. What are their life supports? So maybe the god, which is the primary support that they believe. The trees, that is their primary support of life. The animals that are there now. The hunting, what are the, how can we show them in hunting positions? So here I am making few bushes just to show. Here you can put few leaves just to show that it is in the area with bushes. Just small ones is good enough to show that there. You don't have to be very calculative on that. Now, here I'm making one deer. So, when the deer is moving, we have to, with the practice and observation, we can actually know what is the movement when they are running or being chased. So, here with a twisted neck over here. And this, and the this looks like a deer. So these are pictographs, so you don't really have to make a real kind of a deer. But yes, if I hold it close to it, you will be able to figure out that it's a deer. And it's not one, I'll do one more. So, you all can see it once again. Now the chest, this is their body. Now here the legs will be all stretched. If you see that they are running, you will see that it's all stretched. If they are standing, it will be straight. And a very short, puffy tail. So these are there. Now here, some more bushes to give them a little coverage maybe are here also. Do not do a lot of them so that they will be hidden, because there is always a reason they are made. We do not make overlapping. It's a 2D thing. We do not make hidden pictures inside like this. Now here we will make the whole group of hunters. So holding a spear which is held down right here. This. Then we can give them a bow and an arrow. This is the bow and arrow. This. So different forms you can make. You can also, this is a little more space. Again, then I'll just make somebody who's sitting so that it fills up the space. You're right there. Like this, and for few places which are here, we'll just again make the fill-ups of the bushes. So this is another band which is showing from where they get their food source. So they are, as I told you in the yesterday session also, they were progressive, and as all the tribes, they slowly progressed with. So they started agriculture. So these are all the cattle. You'll see that transport and the cattle are here. Here it is hunting. And now the next one, the main thing that they used to rely on was the fishing. So we will do that also. Here, making boats. So you may make whichever way boat you want. Just one boat here and maybe the other boat. Which whichever shape of boat you want to make, you can make it. It's just showing the activity. Just decorating it a little so that it stays away from the water design. These are the boat. Now we have to make the Sora tribe people sitting. That was the main source of these people, that they used to get the stuff from the river. And just a simple form of fish. That's it. Very, very simple. So the spears, this fish was, fishing was their main thing. Here, just a basket. You can go innovative, but you have to be careful that you do not go against the rules of the making of the picture. It should not be different. It should fall in the category of Sora. You can. Thank you. Now here, this is a basket where now they are gathering also whatever they are, just taking it. So this. Now here, once this is done, we will fill the water. Now do not go very curvy, just make the lines and the simplest water that we can make. Now water will, I'll be making as a second thing. First I will be making fishes so that they do not cross each other. Now here I'm just making a small cover over here, wherein this, maybe this guy is here. This is their net, probably here. And I can just make the net going down. So this is what all can be made. Now making a sitting posture. I'm just taking it by the spear. Now here I can make a small kind of a hut or a shade kind of a thing over here, which will just looking very cute and a small bird. I'll make it here. There. So this almost finishes with our picture and few fish that are living, not coming in their trap there. And this whole thing shows us a beautiful Sora painting. So I will give you the full view of the picture here. this. So the first panel we did is the God and the prayer and the tree. The second is their help, the cattle. The third band shows their hunting and the way of living. And the next is the fishing. So I hope you all like it. Any which way you want the boat to be, there's no specific thing, just a general way how you make a boat, you can make a boat there. It can be long, it can be short, it can be small, it can be canoe, whichever type you want to make. So this is pretty much, and any questions then anybody has, you can ask me so I can answer you. So anybody has any questions regarding the picture or oh, you found it more beautiful than Varli? Good. Varli is also very beautiful. I cannot compare them. But yeah, there is only the dance form that looks more pretty in Sora. That's my personal choice. The pen, I have mentioned many a times. And this is a jelly roll white pen that I used. You want a chit chat video? Sure, I'll try. Okay, thank you so much. And if you have any doubts, you may write. This video will be available after the session also. It will be on the channel. And if you have any comments or any doubts, you can write it there and I will be answering you. We will do a little bit of Zentangle also coming in a line. There are so many things that are lined up. Yes, Gond art. I've got a big list. Patachitra, Kerala mural, Gond art, Zendala, mandalas, and there's so many. Deva black base is just a black color paper pad. Sure. If you have any suggestions, do write it in the comments and I will revert it back to you. Sure. Everything on the way. There's a list coming up here. Okay. So thank you all for joining me today. And I'm really grateful for you, to you all who are helping me to reach at a good place. And thank you all for all the love that you are giving it to me. And I'll keep doing my good. And you keep doing your good. Be creative and keep drawing. Thank you. Bye-bye.